This is the Shrimp Trawler Video Channel Strat-O-Matic Baseball Excel Game of the Week.
Welcome back, baseball fans, to the game of the week. And we are in the final of the National League Divisional Series rounds. We've had the Reds win, the Angels win, the Orioles win. Those three teams are going to the League Championship Series. Those three teams also went to the League Championship Series in 1979, which is one of the four years in this timeline between 1977 and 80. The other team was a team that won it all, the Pirates. But because of realignment, let's look at the standings. Because of realignment in the National League, we went to four divisions, and then we created this North, or this Central, we call it, North or Central. And we pulled the Reds out of the West, the Pirates out of the East, joined the Cardinals and Cubs, and created this intense battle between Reds-Pirates. And the Pirates, frankly, just lost to the Reds, is all it was, and a wild card game. That's why the 79 Pirates are not here. But the battle today, the 4-seed Rockies and the number 1-seed Astros are trying to play into the League Championship Series. Astros will have home field. We've already played game one. I'll get to that shortly. Let's look at the rotation for this five-game series. Colorado does not have much flexibility with their pitching staff. Nobody can pitch on 3 days rest. So because they just played a wild card game, they have to open up with Hal Dews. And again, you're going to see a lot of unusual names for expansion teams because these guys don't have a long career, short sample size. He's good for like one good year. You also see Frank Pastore in game two was really good for the Reds in a short period of time. A very old Jack Billingham. Larry McWilliams, who would find success in the early 80s with the Pirates. After a day off, if it goes to game five, Hal Dews again on 4 days rest. Meanwhile, the Astros are going to go with their man, J.R. Richard, who actually, he can't pitch on 3 days rest either. This is a 1980 card, and if you recall, the poor man suffered a stroke after the All-Star break, and he missed, that was the end of his career. It was rather sad. So Joe Niekro would pitch game two, Doug Rowe three, stolen from the Dodgers, Mark Lemangelo game four, and then back to Richard. But we've played game one in Houston. Let's check that one out. Game one in Houston. It's Hal Dews against J.R. Richard. Astros get an early lead, a double by Rader. Sack fly by Cedeno. 2-0 at home. Nothing big. You know, the Astros are a heavy favorite in the series. But in the fourth inning, a solo homer by Don Money. In the fifth, an RBI double by Rick Auerbach. And then in the sixth, a second homer for Don Money. It's 3-2 at this point. In the eighth inning, they load the bases against Richard. He's pulled, a sack fly, and then Joe Ferguson with a three-run homer. The Rockies are built on the homer, walk, strikeout premise, and they hit one, two, three of them, and those home runs account for six of their seven runs. Astros try and rally late, fall short. Final score in game one, an upset. Colorado defeats J.R. Richard 7-4, and now the Rockies have home field advantage. But game two is, of course, still here in Houston. I'll shut this window down here, and we'll go right into the matchup. So game two from the Dome. They really need this one. Number one seed Astros. The Rockies will send Frank Pastore, a very nice card. He had in 1980 for the Reds, 13-7, 3.26 ERA. His career didn't last long. I don't know if he had arm problems or what happened to him, but he had a nice little run there. And for the Astros, it'll be Joe Niekro, his 1979 card, 21-game winner with an ERA of 3, pitcher of 3 days rest. So let's get started. Must win for the Astros, or you don't want to go down 0-2 and then go on the road. We'll put it that way as far as a must win. Leading off for Colorado will be Wayne Garrett. 68 is a liner to short. Rick Auerbach, 2-8 is a K. Champ Summers, 2-10. Single one to 7, and he lines out on an 18. Dave Collins, 67. Single 1 to 18 is a base hit. Ace Steeler against the zero-arm Ferguson. Astros enjoy running. They're going to try a steal here. And he rolls a 19, and Joe Ferguson throws out Collins to start the game. Not a good start. Denny Walling, 1-8 is a base hit off Walling's card. Cedeno, 2-3, short B. Now he's a double A stealer, and with two outs, he's going to try and steal. And he rolls a 13, and he should be safe. He's a double A, he is. So with two outs, it's Dave Rader. 68 off Pastore is a pop to short. We go to the second. Jason Thompson, 47's a K. Don Money, two big homers in game one. 1-9's a grounder to short. And Ramon Aviles, short little career for the Phillies. Got himself a World Series ring in 1980 as a utility player. 63 is a grounder to pitcher X, and that's an E0. E0 pitchers, we don't roll for the home team, only for the road team. Quickens the game. Bottom of two, Bob Watson, 2-8, grounds are short. Joe Cruz, 1-2, fly ball to right B plus injury. This could be huge for the Astros. Jose Cruz is the heart of the team, and he's hurt in the second inning. They lose a corner outfielder. Dave Collins can play right field for him. And they'll just put Cruz in the DH. They'll just flip DH in outfield spots until it's time to bat again. Bert Campanaris, 1-3, grounds a third. All right, top of the third. Mike Lum, 1-5, base hit for the East Steeler. Joe Ferguson, 2-8 is a walk. Two on, nobody out for Rick Monday. 3-11, let's take a look at Rick Monday's card. 77 card for Monday, not a good one either. 230. Rather strange, I know he had some better years. It must have been, you would have figured that Monday's been with the Rockies since the beginning of this decade, that they would have figured out a way of avoiding the 77 card and getting a better one. But one of the strategies is that at the end of this year, you can immediately bump it up to his Blue Monday card of 1981, and that's a good one. Anyway, 311 is homer, 1-5, double, and that's going to be a two-base hit. Ferguson will hold a third. And the Rockies, look out, folks, are up one zip. Second and third, nobody out. Wayne Garrett, 2-7. Center B question mark for Ferguson, not against Cedeno. Too much of an arm. With one out, they're going to bring the infield up for Rick Auerbach. 3-10 is a K. And with two outs, it's Champ Summers. 4-11 off Niekro, first C. So Niekro settles down, limits the damage to a run. We go to the bottom of the third inning. Mike Cubbage will lead it off. 63, second X. Wayne Garrett is a 4E13 at second base. And that's going to be a base hit. Chicken Stanley. 1-5 is short B. So Stanley's at first in the fielder's choice. Dave Collins. 1-6. Collins, that is a 4-6-3 double play. Not a good look for the Stros early. 1-0 in the fourth. Jason Thompson. 2-11, grounds a second. Don Money, 2-7 is a walk. We talked about Aviles could hit and run here. Money's a C stealer. They have no speed on this team, but they might want to. They're going to do a hit and run here with Ramon Aviles. Hit and run, runner has to steal. Oh boy. Money's a C, which is 11. Not being held on, though. Raiders catching. And do the Rockies have their first stolen base of the year? Yes, they do. So there's your math, folks. Not holding a C-stealer, frankly. When you look at the rest of the speed on Colorado, it's D-D-C-E-C-E-E-E-D. So they didn't hold the C-stealing Don Money. But Raiders got a plus 2 arm, so you just add 2 to 11, you get 13. And you're old 13. And I believe that is the first stolen base of the year for the Colorado Rockies. It comes at a strange time. Trying to steal a 2-0 lead in the Astrodome. I guess it's a case of when in Rome, you know? So Ramon will swing the bat now. 1-7. Let's take a look at this Ramon Aviles card. Sure, I mean, you can hit 277 with this card. Power against righties. Middle infielder. Like I said, he played for the 80 Phils, which means he got a World Series ring. But we saw that B hit and running and said, oh, we have to try it. We have to try it once. I mean, it's the only way the Rockies can get a stolen base. And then we got the stolen base. And then we follow it up with a 1-7, which is single dot dot. And that is how you play Billy Ball or inside or Whitey Ball with the slugging Rockies. 2-0 in the fourth. Mike Lum. 3-10. That's a 4-6-3 double play. A little bit more obvious. Yeah, that's probably the thing they do a lot. Okay. 2-0. Bottom of the fourth. It'll be Denny Walling. 37's a walk. Your tie run. Cesar Cedeno. 48 is short X. But Auerbach is bad. 4-26. That's going to be a single dot. The Rockies, that's their Achilles. They don't value defense. They don't even draft players and look at the defense. They just draft specifically for homers, walks, and strikeouts. That's their strategy. That's what they're sticking with. The idea is to force the opponent to get you out 27 times. Stay out of the double play, stealing bases, even though they broke that rule in the top of the inning. You know, going from first to third, sac flies, all that stuff. But Cedeno has a single. Runners on the corners, and it'll be Dave Rader. 35 is single dot dot, and it's 2-1. Runners on the corners, playing back for Watson. 42 is ground ball to first C. Now, you could have played the infield up, but they don't do things like that because that increases the chance of them getting a hit. And they don't care. That's not how they play the game. They play it a different style. So they let the runner from third walk in and tie the game, and Rader goes to second. He's not pretty that fast. And it'll be the player replacing Jose Cruz in the lineup. Which at this point, that's funny. So after the base running prowess demonstrated by Don Money in the top of the inning, the Astros are going to bring in Jeff Newman to be the new catcher. He of the zero arm. Instead of Dave Rader's plus two arm to slow those Rockies down on the bases. Let's take a look at Jeff Newman. You see, he's got that zero arm catcher. Nice card for him in 1978. He hit 239. So runner at second, one out, Jeff Newman. 2-6, ground ball to short B. And with two outs, it'll be Bert Campanaris. 34, flies left. Nice game, 2-2, top of the fifth, Joe Ferguson. 49, short X. This is going to be Bert Campanaris at short, he's a two, he makes the play. Rick Monday, the big hit earlier, 1-5 is the sky to center. With two outs, it's Wayne Garrett, 67, pops the third. All right. We go to the middle of the fifth, but first, let's pause a moment for station identification.
This is the Shrimp Trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
Ah, yeah, back to that licorice tea, folks. Oh, I think, no, it's peppermint. Yeah. All right, never mind. Mike Cubbage, bottom of fifth. 2-2 game. Mike covered 64 off Pastore, bounces a short. Auerbach, again, bad fielder, 426, another single. Back-to-back innings, hits off the shortstop. Don't like to see that. Chicken Stanley, 1-4, center field. Dave Collins, forced to play the outfield today. He's in right field. 54, off Pastore, hit the card. Homer, 1-5, double. That's going to be a double to center field. Cubbage is a 12-runner. Will not run against Monday. So you got second and third with one out. They will bring it up this time for Denny Walling. This is a 2-2 tie. 5-12, first C. Runners hold. The infield up in that particular situation. Save the run that time. Time the strategy worked. Second and third for Cesar Cedeno. Before he bats, let's take a look at the Cesar Cedeno card of 1978. I believe he got injured. He only had 192 at-bats. We liked about this card, of course, is the incredible defense, the double-A stealing, and the fact that he hits righties better than lefties, such as this particular moment. So here is the pitch to Cesar Cedeno. 58 off Pastore is single, 1-11 line out, and he rolls a 14. Tough break for the Stros, trying to get a lead. They cannot get it. And we stay tied at 2, going to the 6th. Necro and Pastore are both starter 7s. Here's Auerbach in the 6th. 67, pops a short. Champ Summers. 1-5, skies to right. Jason Thompson, 57, short X. Campanaris can field, he's a 2E29, makes the play. Bottom of the 6th, Dave Rader, 59, second X. This is Garrett, 4E13, and a single. They have gotten infield hits in 3 straight innings off of Auerbach, and Garrett. Bob Watson. 2-4, skies the center. Jeff Newman. 59 off Pastore is a K. And with 2 outs, it's Burt Campanaris. 36, ground to short. Top of the 7th. 2-2 tie. Yeah, you got to break Necker to get him out of there, particularly in a potential 0-2 game. Don Money, 210, is hit by the pitch. Do we do it again, folks? Oh, we got to, don't we? The dreaded hit and run that got the Rockies their very first stolen base in the last 2 years, maybe? Aviles will hit and run. He has to run again on the 7, but this time he rolls a 19 and is tagged out a few strides before second base. So, yeah. That was a waste. That was a waste. And a 2-2 game, too. So Aviles will hit away here. 47's a walk. And they're a batter away from breaking this dude. Mike Lum. 35. Skies are right with 2 outs and a man on. Joe Ferguson. 57 is a K. So, that was a rather big unusual move for a team to do in a pretty tense situation. A 2-2 tie and a chance to go up 2-0 on the road, but I just kind of foobarred it for these guys by forcing a hit and run situation, something they don't normally do, as I outlined earlier. It worked once, it got on a run, it didn't work the other time, and it's a 2-2 game in the bottom of the 7th inning. Stretch time, we are listening to Gene Clark's No Other LP from 74. There Must Be Some Misunderstanding and Strength of Strings, Silver Raven. Great LP by the tragic Gene Clark there. Bottom of the 7th inning, Pastore, starter 7. He's the ace of the team. Because he can only pitch on 4 days rest, you might want to get as many innings as you can out of him. And he will continue. So it'll be Mike Cubbage leading off in the bottom of the 7th. 2-9, skies the center. Chicken Stanley, 1-7's a walk. Dave Collins, 46 is a sky to right. Denny Walling, 39 is a walk. And here it is, folks. Got to break Pastore here. 2 on and 2 out again. Cedeno, just like in the 5th. He had two men on the first. He got out. He got a single in the fourth. Scored a run. But he got out again in the fifth. Another clutch moment here for the heartbeat of the Houston Astros. Cesar Cedeno. Here's the pitch to Cesar. 1-3 is a sky to right. Hate to see that. All right. We'll go to the eighth. Negro, vulnerable to breaking with a couple batters in the eighth. Almost certainly if he breaks, they're just going to go to Sam Beto because you figure this is a must win for the Astros to even the series. So it'll be Rick Monday to leading off. 37's a K. Wayne Garrett, 5'11". Pitcher X, E0, I don't roll. For an E0 pitcher, I know he could give up a hit on a roll of a 1 or a 2. But he could do that on the road, not at home. Speeds the game up. I've been doing this for like 16 years with that rule. So anyway, Rick Auerbach, 69, skies the center field. Bottom of the eighth. Pastore isn't going anywhere. Similar situation in Negro. Vulnerable to breaking with a couple base runners. Both guys walked a couple guys in the seventh. It'll be Dave Rader. 2-7. Grounds a second. Bob Watson. 2-5 is hit by the pitch. And Jeff Newman, injury replacement here. Newman, 56 off Pastore, skies the right field. And with two outs, Burt Campanaris. 1-6 is a grounder to short. And both guys get a reset. They cannot break in the ninth unless you put three guys on. Pastore or Negro will take this to the ninth, but not the tenth. Here's Champ Summers in a 2-2 game. 47 is a K. Jason Thompson, 48, second X. This is Chicken Stanley. He's a 3, and he makes the play at second. And Don Money. 1-6, let's take a look at the Don Money card. 1-6, homer, 1-10, double. He misses the homer in cavernous Astrodome. It's a double, a 420-foot double for Money. Tough break there. Had two homers in game one. And so here we are with Ramon Avias, who finally gets to hit with Money on base instead of hitting and running. So the pitch to Ramon Avilés. 57 off of Negro is a strikeout. That'll conclude the 9 innings for Negro. I don't let only guys who can pitch into the 10th inning are starter 9s. So Negro will be gone. And it'll be Pastore trying the same thing. Mike Cubbage leading off in the 9th. 38 for Cubbage is a clean single to center field. He's a 12 runner. Nobody faster on the bench. And you got Fred Stanley, an A bunter, with Collins, Walling, and Cedeno after him. I think I might want to bunt here against the tough Pastore. Even though it's only 1-12, the thing about base running is the home team can run on any situation they want. The road team has to run on 14 and or better. So if I want to run with the Astros, I can run with them. That's another one of my home field advantages. So Stanley will bunt here. The bunt is a roll of a 6, and that is a successful bunt. So the winning run is on second base. It'll be Dave Collins, Denny Walling, and Cedeno, and then Rader. Three of the next four batters are left-handed. But Pastore is the dude for the Rockies, and they won game one. They're going to run this kid out here and hope for extras. So here we go. Dave Collins, the pitch to Dave. 6'11", pitcher X, have to roll it, E24, not a good E rating, a 2E24 pitcher, and this is an error. Now, you could say, well, that's not fair, yeah, you didn't roll E rating for Negro, but you did for Pastore, and it's like, yeah, well, it's in the Astrodome, gang. So we got runners on the corners with two outs. With one out, excuse me. Runners on the corners with one out. They will bring the infield up. We'll use that bit of strategy. Collins is an ace stealer anyway, so you would do that. Hold him. And this is Denny Walling. He's not broken. Matter of fact, he can't break without losing the game. because he would have to put two guys on base, and one of those would obviously score. So they're going to bring it up with for Denny Walling. The pitch to Denny. 110, Denny Walling. Let's take a look at the card. That's a clean single to center field. That will win the game for the Astros. Tough loss for the Rockies. 3-2, but they were playing with house money. They won game one. They had Don Money steal a base. I mean, the Rockies almost got the 2-0 lead. They have to settle for the split. Pastore pitched very well into the ninth inning, but he's an E24 pitcher, which means more than half the time you're going to make an error on an E rating. Now, that's a bad E rating, and that really cost him. So he himself is responsible for that. Both pitchers get complete games. Let's do the box here. So Nico gets a complete game victory, with victory determined after he had left. The two runs were earned. Walk four, struck out seven. Gets a complete game. Tough loss or pass story. 10 hits, 3 runs. The first two were earned. The third one was not. He walks four, strike out one. He gets a complete game as well. 1-0-0-9, 0-1-0-8 in the third, 3-10, 2-4. 4-7-4-1. Rockies can still win this game in Colorado and not have to go back to the Astrodome. So that's what they're thinking. Home cooking. You see how the home field worked for the Astros in this game. It can work for the Rockies in the next two games. So let's look at the year-to-date numbers of both squads. Some interesting numbers to look at. We'll start with the Astros. Best record in the National League. They squeaked it out over the Reds as the Reds were losing to the Pirates near the end of the season. So after splitting the first two games, they're 10-500 at 19-9. A .282 hitting team. A .318 team ERA. Joe Niekro is their best successful pitcher at 6-1. Sambito does have 7 saves. Also 2 losses. The leading RBI man for your Astros, no surprise here, is Bob Watson with 27 RBI. As far as stolen bases, you do have Dave Collins with 16 and Cesar Cedeno with 14. And you might as well mention Jose Cruz with 11. 3 guys in double digits in just 28 games. That's a speedy club. Dave Collins has 46 hits, hitting almost .350. To pace the team. So this is a very solid Astro team. This is no fluke. They are very good. They were in the National League West with the Reds and Dodgers, and you know they had to wait their turn. This is a division-winning team of 1980, which would have included J.R. Richard, at least for the first half of the season, till the man suffered the stroke and was no longer on the roster for the second half, which is a really bummer. But at least they have Richard in this version of the franchise. And let's take a look at Colorado. 8-19-14, hitting .263 with a .434 ERA. They're not advertising for Cy Young winners when they put the staff together. Pastore's 5-2 after a tough loss there. Ron Reed's got 6 saves in the bullpen. What's interesting is the homers are not particularly glaring here. I'm looking at Joe Ferguson with 8 homers and 27 RBI. He leads the team in both categories. He's been batting 8th all year. That's pretty interesting. Dan Ford from the California Angels has leading his team in homer and RBI, batting 8th all year. So that sometimes happens in Strat. Auerbach, 4,429, pacing the hitting. So year-to-date for this carryover league, in 484 games played thus far, this league is hitting .268 with a .407 ERA. Slightly better pitching than normal. So that's kind of good. I like to see that. So with the series tied at a game apiece, I will report the results of the rest of the series at the end of this video. When we go to Colorado, it'll be Doug Rao against Jack Billingham, and then McWilliams against Lemangelo, and then if the series goes back to the Astrodome, Hal Dews and J.R. Richard. Thanks for checking out the video. We'll see you next time. Okay, so this is what happened. So this is the box score after the Astros got the split in game two, 3-2. So we'll go to game three in Colorado. It's Doug Rao, a lefty who's oddly bet against left-handed batters, against Jack Billingham. We expected fireworks, because Summers can hit lefties, Monday can hit lefties, asking Jason Thompson. So you're already leaving three lefties in the game. However, the Astros get a run in the third inning, a two-out single by Cesar Cedeno. It's one zip. Doug Rao sails through six shutout innings. 1-0 is all we got out of Jack Billingham and Doug Rao into the bottom of the seventh when Joe Ferguson leads off the bottom of the seventh with a solo shot tied at one. Then in the pivotal eighth inning, Billingham is already pulled by this time. Sid Mangi, the lefty, is out there. Strikes out Campanaris. They pinch at Cubbage. Bernard, who singles. Stanley singles. They get a Collins ground out, put second and third with two outs. Mangi faces the lefty Walling, but he walks him. So with the bases loaded and two outs, unfortunately, Mangi's broken. So they decide to bring Rich Hinton, another lefty, in because Cedeno doesn't hit lefties very well. Well, guess what happens, folks? Cedeno rolls 2-5 on his own card against lefties. A grand slam! Swinging the National League Divisional Series between the Astros and Rockies. Grand slam in the eighth inning. Bingo! That's your ball game. 5-1 Astros. So now, our hopes dashed in Colorado for game four. Well, game four, Mark Lemangelo for the Astros against Larry McWilliams. First lefty the Astros have seen in the series. And it's Larry McWilliams trying to even it up for his Rockies. CGSO, four hit shutout. Another low scoring game. Rockies get three in the first. Add homers in the sixth and seventh innings. Rockies get the 6-0 emphatic win. It's been a back and forth series. Rockies win one, Astros win two and three. Rockies come back and win four. So we'll go back to game five in Houston. Same matchup, Hal Dews, the number four starter for Colorado, bested Junior Richard, the number one pitcher on the Astros in game one. What happens in game five? Final score, Houston 17, Colorado 2. Emphatically, this is not a contest between J.R. Richard and Hal Dews. Hal, unfortunately, did not make it out of the third inning. His line, 2 2/3 innings, 8 hits, 10 runs, 8 are earned, walked 9, struck out, zip. I mean, they could have put his bullpen in sooner than that, but Rich Hinton, he got knocked around. Sosa got knocked around. Ron Reed got knocked around. 17-2 is 17-2, folks. Not much you can do. And Junior Richard's got a 184 ERA or something like that. I doubt he's going to give up 16 runs or 17 runs on his start. So, yep, pretty anticlimactic finale, other than the fact that the Astros are the number one seed, and when the rubber meets the road, they put a whooping down on the Rockies, the expansion team, all over. Astros will go on to the National League Championship Series, hosting it against the Cincinnati Reds, Reds and Astros, who were actually in the same division during this era, will meet in the National League Championship Series, which would not have normally happened. American League Championship Series, Baltimore and California. Fun Final Four. All have playoff resumes. We'll see how it goes. Great Final Four to look forward to. Thanks for everybody for checking this stuff out. We'll see you next time.